By the rubric that reflect the number of observations and inferences and supporting evidence for the references made, or inferences made. The quantitative data for the writing also examine the difference in the mean scores between the classes and gender for closing time points, and self-assessment questionnaire, was also used to evaluate self-confidence and also respectful class discussions at mean and also post-study. And the quantitative data for both self-confidence and peer respect were separately processed to examine the difference in the mean scores between the two classes and gender for three study time points. And finally, observational notes were taken briefly after every discussion. These images were used for four study time points. The students showed signs of fatigue looking at the same image, so during the post study, another version of Snapta with the painting, but same artist was used, as well as a new image. This is created here in post one and in post two. The result. Observational notes indicated that class A had unfocused discussions due to disruptive behavior. They were just talking and arguing during the discussion time, and that was noted by the homeroom teachers as well. I was not aware of first few times. But that lasted entire BTS sessions over 8 weeks. On the other hand, class B had focused discussions due to attuned behavior. Another interesting finding was some students in both classes who did not normally engage in art class were so interested in the discussion and even willing to speak out. And as for the questionnaire data for both self-confidence and peer respect, overall, there was no statistical improvement in either class or gender comparison. So this is class comparison and self-confidence and peer respect. And then the one means they strongly disagree to all the self-confidence questions. And five means they strongly agree to the question. And this is class A, class B, and pre, mid, post. And same thing here for the peer respect. Class A showed slightly higher self-confidence and peer respect at the pre-study, but that declined or stayed level during the mid and post-study. And class B stayed level most of the time points. And I interpreted that this data that apparently the observed behavior trends in the class B, class A, and class B were somehow reflected in the class comparison results. Remember, class A had really disruptive behavior, class B had really focused attuned behavior. As for gender comparison, females showed higher self-confidence at all time points, and male felt more peer respect. So this is gender comparison self-confidence. You see male, female, pre, mid, post. This is peer respect, pre, as for the data for the writing assessment, class A's with disruptive behavior might have contributed to no improvement in their writing, whereas class B showed gradual improvement. So this is the class comparison for the writing assessment, and pre, mid, post one and two, and you can see compared to class A, it's kind of steady, and the class B has gradual improvements. As for gender comparison, both gender increased their writing scores. So you can see right here to male and female, and pre-B, post one and two. reasons our females might have picked up their discussions with teens more easily, but also able to transfer the skill to their writing. And another literature indicates that gender influences how children learn and behave due to developmental gender differences in the brain. The areas involved in the language and fine motor skills in the brain mature about 6 years earlier in girls than in boys. And also the area involved in the targeting and spatial memory mature about 4 years earlier in boys than in girls. This explains why females perform better in writing, and which might have contributed to higher self-confidence levels, as we saw earlier. So over here, higher self-confidence, and then higher writing results. In conclusion, because of the inquiry-based, non-threatening, open-ended group discussion style using familiar art images, BTS is a really mindful way to enhance visual literacy in elementary students. BTS surely encourages students to observe and think and interact with art and also with each other. And BTS effectively promotes critical thinking, promotes students' writing by making their thoughts more complete and organized, and holds great potential for cultivating students' self-confidence and a respectful class culture. Respect for class culture also greatly affects the student's academic achievement, as you saw in the graph. Class B had a lot more success in writing. Implementing BTS for a longer period of time might result in a further growth in the study areas, and I'm very looking forward to conduct a year-long study, which Filipino one usually suggests. So 9 BTS sessions, but not be 9 monthly BTS sessions, and 10th is the museum visit, and do the actual BTS session. And finally, all educators should be aware of the gender difference in brain development and implement strategies that would engage both boys and girls in the classroom. And this is something that I was not aware, but when I saw the result, I realized that there must be something going on. So that's the area that I like to keep studying and then implement in my teaching. Thank you so much. Yeah.
I hope you have strong confidence that next year in your position as an art teacher that you will be able to use this technique and it will fit with your curriculum regardless of what it is. Do you feel like it's flexible enough that no matter what you could fit in?
That's a very good question. Their reading coach is super interested in BTS. Good. And she knows about it. She wants to learn more. So she asked me about it, if I can talk and learn together. And although District 2 supposedly have art curriculum there, so I need to follow certain curriculum of whatever they have. But they told me they can somehow make it happen.
Okay. So that's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah.